and welcome to the session on sequence and series. This is brought to you by Handa Kafanda. There are three primary kind of series that we have: the arithmetic progression, the geometric progression, and the harmonic progression. Let us look at them one by one. In case of arithmetic progression, the difference between two terms remains constant. For example, the terms can be a, a plus d, a plus 2d, and so on. As you can see, the difference between any two terms is d, and that is remaining constant. The nth term of a series is given by a plus n minus 1 into d. Sum till n terms is given by n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. If you are given the first term and the last term, then also you can find out the sum. It will be n by 2 into t1 plus tn, where t1 is the first term and tn is the last term. Suppose a question asks you to assume three terms in an AP. You can very well assume them as a, a plus d, and a plus 2d. But it would be better if you assume a minus d, a, and a plus d. How does this help? It helps me because if I add all three of them, d and d will cancel out with each other, and I will be left with just 3a. If I am supposed to assume 5 terms, I will do a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, and a plus 2d. If I am asked to assume 7 terms, it will start from a minus 3d to a plus 3d. I hope you get the drift. The problem, however, will come in the case of an even number of terms. Suppose I have 4 terms, a minus d, a plus d, and a plus 2d. That won't help me because all the d's will not cancel out. If I take it as a minus 2d, a and a plus d, even that will not help because all d's will not cancel out. So what should I take? You may pause the video if you like. In this particular case, you should take a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d, and a plus 3d. Why have I done this? Because if I add all of it up, I am just left with 4a. And also the point to note is that the difference between any two consecutive terms is not d as in the cases above. It is 2d. In case of a geometric progression, the ratio of two consecutive terms remains constant. That is, let's say the terms are a, ar, ar square, and so on. In this case, the nth term is given by a r to the power n minus 1. Sum till n terms is given by a r to the power n minus 1 by r minus 1. It can also be given by a 1 minus r to the power n by 1 minus r. It depends which formula you use. That is defined by the value of r, or the common ratio. If r is greater than 1, then you need to use this formula. If r is less than 1, then you need to use this formula. Sometimes you are also asked for sum till infinite terms. That is possible if and only if the common ratio is less than 1 and it is given by a by 1 minus r. Very similar to AP, if you have to assume 3 terms in a GP, they should be a by r, a, and ar. 5 terms in a GP should be a by r square, a by r, a, ar, and ar square. Why am I doing them like this? Because the product in this case is a cube. The product in this case is a to the power 5. All the r and all powers of r cancel out with each other. Very similar to AP, if I have to assume 4 terms in a GP, they will be a by r cube, a by r, ar, cube. As the common difference in that case becomes 2d, the common ratio in this particular case becomes r square. Terms are said to be in a harmonic progression if their reciprocals are in a neighborhood. What I mean is, a1, a2, a3, and an will be in a harmonic progression if 1 by a1, 1 by a2, 1 by A3 and 1 by AN are in an AP. What I mean is something like 1 by 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, These are terms of a harmonic progression because their reciprocals, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they are in an AP. Let us do an analysis of the three series, taking them at the same time. Arithmetic mean of terms is given by A1 plus A2 till An by N. The geometric mean is given by A1 into A2 into A3 till An to the power of 1 by N. And the harmonic mean of N values is given by N by 1 by A1 plus 1 by A2 till 1 by An. Always remember that the arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to the geometric mean, is greater than or equal to the harmonic mean. This formula is always true. The equality sign, however, happens in one and only one case. That is when all the values, that is A1, A2, An, they are all the same. Suppose all of them are 5. Then the arithmetic mean will be 5 plus 5 plus 5 n times 5n by n or 5. Geometric mean will be 5 into 5 into 5 n times 5 to the power n, 1 by n, 5 again. Harmonic mean will be n by 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5 till 1 by 5 for the nth time. This will also come out to be 5. There is another formula which holds true in case of geometric mean and arithmetic mean. That is, arithmetic mean into harmonic mean is geometric mean square. But please remember, this formula is applicable if and only if you are considering two values, A and B. Please remember, it's a very common mistake that people tend to make. They apply this formula anywhere and everywhere. That is not the case. It is applicable once again only when you have two values, A and B. The arithmetic mean of two values is given by A plus B by 2. The geometric mean is given by root AB. And the harmonic mean is given by 2AB by A plus B. As you can see for yourself here, A plus B, if I multiply AM and HM, A plus B and A plus B will cancel, 2 and 2B will cancel, I will be left with just AB, which is nothing else but the geometric mean whole square. Please stay tuned with us to continue the discussion on sequence and series. Thank you.